Today's video is sponsored by Recoverit from Wondershare. Well, hi everyone and welcome to Pal the Tech. I've mentioned before that your SD card is the single most important component of your camera. It doesn't matter how good you are with lighting or composition or focus or exposure or creativity, you can lose it all in a matter of seconds if your SD card gets corrupted or accidentally erased. It's important that you have a solid understanding of the various types of SD card problems that you may encounter, as well as how to recover from them. Generally speaking, damage to SD cards can fall into one of two main categories: physical damage to the card itself, or corruption or loss to the data itself. An SD card that's been physically damaged is the most serious problem you'll encounter. This would include cards that are bent, cracked, broken, crushed, or burned. In many cases, it's just not possible to recover data from physically damaged cards. With serious physical damage, you will be forced to send the card to a professional data recovery service and just hope for the best. It can cost hundreds of dollars and take up to a week or more if they can save the data on the card at all. However, there are some less serious types of physical damage that you can fix yourself. For example, here's my SD card giving me the middle finger. In this case, I was able to apply a light amount of superglue to the top and use a toothpick to bend it back and stick it to the card. From there, I quickly inserted it into my laptop and I was able to get all of my photos off of it. Sometimes the metal contacts on the card itself can get dirty, and that can cause data reading issues. What I like to do is use a Q-tip and lightly clean them. That can actually put the card at least into a readable state so you can get your photos off of it. Other times, that little read-only lock switch can break. This can be fixed with a paper clip and some super glue, and if you want to try that out, there's plenty of tutorials. Just search YouTube. However, by far the most common problems are not a card that's broken, but the data inside the card is corrupted or lost. Now, this generally falls into three categories. The first is that your computer cannot read or recognize the SD card at all. This could be an operating system problem, an SD card reader problem, or a file formatting issue. If you don't have any photos on your card, one of the best fixes is to reset the card by formatting it in the exFAT file system. On a Mac, open Disk Utility and choose exFAT from the dropdown and then format the SD card. Remember though that by doing so, you will erase all of the data on the card. If you're using Windows, right-click the SD card and choose Format, and make sure you select exFAT and not NTFS. Once your SD card is formatted, remember to always remove it by ejecting it, not just pull it in and out, right? Right-click and select Eject. This will go a long way toward preventing possible data corruption issues. Now, once you've removed the card, put the card back in the camera, right? And try formatting it from there. On Fujifilm, I like to press and hold down the delete button and then press the rear command dial. Once formatted, the card will be reset back to the best state for the camera to begin using it. The second category is having a file, such as a photo or a video, become corrupted in your camera. One of the main causes of this is actually pulling out the SD card before your camera has finished writing to it. This can happen when people get a little too excited to see what they got when they were shooting in burst mode. So you always want to be sure that the green and amber lights on the back of the camera are no longer flashing before you remove the card. Another cause of photo or video corruption is having your battery die out or get removed while your camera's writing to the SD card. Now, Fujifilm cameras are very good at preventing this sort of thing, but if you use a dummy battery on AC power and you accidentally disconnect the cable, this could happen. And lastly, the final and most frustrating way of all to lose your data is to accidentally delete it. Fortunately, there are an ever-increasing number of tools that you can use to restore not just your lost photos, but your lost videos as well. One tool that I recommend is called Recoverit from Wondershare. It was released in 2003 and works on both Mac and Windows PCs. It can recover not only photos, but also videos, audio files, emails, and more than 1,000 other file formats. It can also rescue your data from a crashed PC by allowing you to create a bootable USB drive. It'll actually use codec information in a video that you shot in the past to use and match up and help restore your recently corrupted video. Once you download and install the software, you are immediately presented with a screen of all of your hard drives and attached storage devices. Recovery could not be simpler. Just select your drive or SD card, and the program will start scanning it. It will then find all kinds of files that you never knew you had, some even dating back months ago, like these I had deleted weeks ago of my son in band practice. Once you've located the file you want to recover, it will save the recovered files back to your computer. It's as simple as that. But does it work well with Fujifilm RAW files? Let's find out. For my test, I'm going to be shooting 3 photos, all of them in RAW format, all of them uncompressed RAW. Okay, here's photo number 1. Here's photo number 2. And here's photo number 3. And as you can see, all 3 of these photos are on the SD card. I am going to delete the photo of the Rubik's Cube. Okay, I've just deleted the photo of the Rubik's Cube. Now let's see what's left on the SD card. Oops, photo's gone. Well, first thing, take your SD card. Can I ever take an SD card out of the camera without it flying around the studio? Let me try it again. First thing, take the SD card out of the camera and put the SD card in your computer. You'll see the SD card appear right in your list of connected drives. Go ahead and run a scan on it. And this can take anywhere from 30 seconds to up to 10 minutes, depending upon how big the SD card is and what the program finds. Okay, now that it's complete, it has found 15 files. As a shortcut, you can click right over to the file type and immediately see your photos or your videos. Have a look at this. There's my JPEG, there's my RAW. That's pretty funny, there's actually 2 of them. I'm gonna go with the original RAW, the original JPEG, and click on Recover. And save it to my documents. Look at that, it even sorted it by type. There's the file. Perfect, it recovered it perfectly, even though I had deleted it from the SD card on the camera. Let's do one more test. This time I'm gonna take 3 separate photos and then I'm gonna completely reformat the card in the camera and let's see if we can recover any of them. Okay, here's photo number 1. Here's photo number 2. And here's photo number 3. There's 1, there's 2, there's 3. Okay, there they are. Okay, let's now format the card, pressing the trash can, holding down that icon, and pressing rear command dial, reformatting slot 1. Okay, there it is. It's now shown up. I'm gonna go ahead and click scan. Look at that. It's completed with 260 files found. And that's what happens when you run a scan on an SD card that's been formatted in the camera. It'll dig up all kinds of old files. But have a look at this. There's 1 of them. And this is funny. You can tell at one point I put this SD card into a Canon camera because look at this file type. I'm too lazy to wait for all of these to load. So what I'm going to do is simply select all of them, all of the JPEGs and the RAW files, and I'm going to click recover, and that's going to put it in my documents folder. I'm going to go ahead and save. Okay, they're complete. I'm going to open up the folder. Let's look at my RAW files. There it is. There's 1 photo. There's the other photo. And it looked like it was able to recover 2 out of 3 of the photos that I shot. The one that did not come out was the photo I took of this little toy camera here. And I'm so glad this happened because this is a powerful reminder to always be careful when you're formatting your cards. Well, as you can see, the recovery software recovered 75% of the photos. It's impossible for it to always get everything back. And you will never get everything back guaranteed if you format your card. It's a little different when you delete them one by one. When you completely format your card and wipe out all your photos, I was still able to get a 75% recovery rate, which is really good. I will leave links down below where you can check out Recover It further. They also have a free version that allows you to recover up to 100 megabytes of files at no charge. I do want to thank Wondershare for supporting this channel. With regard to losing photos, we've all been there. However, having a good understanding of what your recovery options are, you stand at least a fighting chance of getting some of them back. Well, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found the video helpful or at least entertaining. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will be back in an all-new video very soon. Take care.